Hi, my name's Oscar Kennedy and I play Jamie. So Jamie is a young, kind of slightly socially awkward lad from Sheffield. He's had a pretty troubled home life and he's lost the only person that he cares about and that cares about him, his sister Pippa. And essentially, where we find him at the start of the show is him pursuing his sole motive, which has become to find where his sister is, as she's gone missing on aboard the Sacramentum. So, yeah. I think just Ryan's writing, like, I've never read a script that's so out there, but also, like, you can really get a sense of the characters, and I think he manages to blend, like, the genres of horror and comedy so perfectly, and I've always been a massive fan of the comedy horror genre, so yeah, that was the big draw for me. I think it's that roller coaster of being on the edge of your seat and then having the slight comic relief. I mean, if it's done well, you have that slight comic relief and then you're just brought right back to the edge of your seat and you're freaking out. And I think it's that thing of, you know, when you're on a roller coaster, you know, you're going up and that's the anxiety, that's the anticipation. And once you go down, you have the fun and the relief. And then you're going straight back up the peak and it's just that kind of like constant up and down. And yeah, that's what I love about comedy horror.
Jamie's on a pretty eventful ride throughout this series. Can you talk about some of the other characters, both friend and foe, that he encounters along the way?
Yeah, so the one to mention is Vivian, who essentially becomes his soulmate. Like, I think it's almost like they were siblings that were split at birth. Like, they are just a yin and yang of each other. Vivian is so strong-willed and unapologetically, you know, who she is and says what she wants and does what she wants, whereas Jamie's kind of a bit kind of on the back foot, and I think they help each other kind of find themselves in the show, and I think that's what's so lovely about their relationship. And then a foe would have to be Quacky, probably. Yeah, Quacky is everyone's foe. No one gets on with Quacky.
And for people who obviously haven't seen the series, without spoiling anything, can you tell us just a little bit about who and what Quacky is?
Quacky's a psychopathic duck murderer. I don't know that I can go any further with that. I think that's who he is.
You talked about the relationship that your character has with Vivian. Can you talk about the real-life relationship you had on set with the wonderful actress who's playing her?
Yeah, Thaddea is someone unlike anyone I've met before. She is so thoughtful and caring and kind and so selfless. Like, when it comes to acting, but also not when acting, like, she is just one of the nicest human beings, and I'm so lucky to have been on this ride with her, because I wouldn't have wanted to do it with anyone else. She is, like, just the best. She is the best.
In terms of your own experiences from set, do you have a most precious memory, one that makes you smile the most or laugh the most when you think about it now?
God, there's so many. I think it's really hard to boil down into one memory, but I think any scene where it was kind of an ensemble piece, where we were all together in a scene, just because we all got to spend that time together, we all became such a family very quickly. Like, not it wasn't towards the end of the show that we were a tight-knit family. Like, we very early on became a family, so it was always fun to have all of us together on set and to spend that time with each other. I think, like I mentioned earlier, that Ryan's writing really kind of, you know, he doesn't write characters that are singularly faceted. Like, these are real, these seem like real characters and real people, and they have real lives. And I think people will become very easily invested in these characters. And I think that is what will drive people who maybe aren't massively fans of comedy horror. I think just caring about the characters and getting to know them and watching them go through this journey together, I think that will be a big enough selling point for them to watch.
Do you think that there is more story to tell with these characters, with this world, if you got the opportunity?
I mean, I think there's definitely, I don't know, if there were an opportunity to pursue that, then I would love to be on board with it. But we'll just have to wait and see.
You've already had a very exciting premiere event at Fright Fest. Can you talk about what it meant for you to be part of Europe's biggest horror festival?
Yeah, it was cool. I mean, I'd never been to anything like that before. I'd never been to Fright Fest before. And yeah, man, it was really cool to go to a festival that is specifically for horror fans and to see how, you know, how much it means to them, the genre of horror, and to see how excited they get to see new shows coming out. It was like really, really a cool thing to see and to be a part of. So yeah, it was a blast.
Why do you think that horror as a genre seems to have a more devoted fan base and a bigger community feel than almost any other type of cinema?
I think it's because, I don't know, I feel like a lot of horror builds a cult following, and I think whenever there's like a cult following behind something, people kind of collectively get together and talk about it, and I feel like maybe that is what gives it that kind of that real fan devotion, because people are being social about these films rather than just ingesting it and going on with their lives. People are talking about it and comparing different films and stuff like that. So yeah, I'd say that. I hope people watch the show and they see the amount of effort and time that we put into making it, and I just hope that people fall in love with these characters the way that we as cast and crew have fallen in love with them. And yeah, I can't wait to see everyone's reactions.